Well, take two, because I thought my phone was screwed. Hopefully this one works or I'll be annoyed. So the audio, when I played back the video, it was because I always check. The audio sounded like it was extremely distorted, and it was like I don't know, a piezoelectric speaker of some kind. It was just this noise, basically. You couldn't understand any of it. I'm like, damn, my phone's screwed. But I reset it, and it works fine now, I think. I think. Yeah, there's a issue with the A series, Samsung A series, that it will do that now and then, and resetting it seems to fix it. So, yeah. Which would be a bummer if it did it while I had a phone call, because then nobody could understand what the hell I was saying, you know. Anyways, it's minus 12 Celsius, which is about 10 degrees Fahrenheit. So it's not warm outside. It's not warm outside. It snowed. There's about an inch of snow on the ground and the roof of the building over here and the parking lot and everywhere in sight. It was windy as hell for a little while there, but now it's seems to have calmed down quite a bit. Yeah, I've been watching The Gift on Netflix, and I've been enjoying it. I've got two episodes left, and hopefully it sort of ties together a bunch of things, because it's very mysterious, and you don't know what's really going on. You just know the one woman is some sort of ancient mystic snake goddess thing. By the time you get to episode six, you realize she's the snake goddess, whatever that is. And it's kind of interesting so far, because it's very involved, and the her boyfriend's father is a bad guy and wants to use her somehow, but you don't know how. And he's done some bad things in relation to the temple that she's associated with, and it's very involved, and it's very mysterious, and it's quite an interesting show. In episode six, you see the bad guy, the father, talking to the TV of all things, and it's talking back to him, and it's got some weird language that we don't understand, and they don't translate it. There's no subtitles, and he's just responding to it in English and all this, and it's like, what the, you know? So that just adds to the mystery, of course. Yeah. It's fascinating. It's made in Turkey, I do believe. The temple that they show, anyways, is in Turkey, I think. I think it's in Turkey. It's a very, very ancient temple. It was found a few years ago, or actually kind of quite a long time ago, relatively, but not really a long time ago, but it was about 20 years ago, I guess. And it's very, very old. Older than any other temple that they found, anyways. And they play into that in the show. It's kind of fun, kind of interesting. Got a mark on my arm. Oh, well. I watched the first episode of What's It There? Fraggle Rock over on Prime, and I didn't like it. Like most of the stuff that I used to like as a child, I don't like it now at all. I find it bad. And I didn't like this one at all either. So, my next one here is going to be Space 1999, which I have saved on YouTube. So I'm going to watch that. I know season two is bad. I remember season two being bad, but I really, really liked season one. It was one of the best sci-fi shows of the time when they had season one. Although they never seemed to run out of pilots. They explain in season two why they don't run out of eagles, even though they blow one or two of them up an episode, and there was only 12 to start with. They're mining the moon, and they have a foundry, and they make more. So, yeah, which makes sense, but they should be running out of pilots. There's only 100 or some 160 people on the moon base or whatever. So, yeah, you think you'd run out of qualified pilots after a while, after them blowing up so often. But yeah, other than that, it's really kind of a good series in the first season. And then it was sold from the UK production company to the USA, a different production company in the USA, and they wrecked it. They destroyed it. Garbage bag monsters is all I have to say. Garbage bag monsters. Yeah. I'm not even kidding. Not to mention the mysterious replacement of the doctor. The doctor was replaced. The head scientist guy is a different person all of a sudden, and it's just what the. Yeah. And they threw in some shape-shifting woman just because they could. Yeah. Oh well. I'll watch it anyways. Well, I'm watching the snow drift off the roof over here. Yeah, I hate snow. I really do. It was so pristine, I had to take a picture in the morning because there was no footprints and there was no tire tracks or anything, so I took a picture out the window of the parking lot and posted it on my Instagram. Yeah, there was, however, a reflection on the window that I failed to notice, but oh well, life goes on. Yeah, since I took it through the window. Yeah. Good thing Grumpy didn't see me because he think I was taking this picture out the window like he was thinking people were doing. Good golly, I can't even imagine. What are you like, watching the windows as you walk through the parking lot or the front of the building and to see if somebody's in there and you think they're taking your picture? Jesus, he's the one that ripped me up for sitting in this spot. What a whack job. Oh well. And there seems to be only a few people that he'll talk to. You have to be, if you're, he perceives you to be under a certain age, he won't talk to you at all. He won't even acknowledge your existence. It's just bizarre. And then the people that he does talk to, it seems that all he wants to do is complain about life. I mean, just completely complain. So, I guess it's a good thing he doesn't want to talk to us young folk because we ain't got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Yeah. Anyways, yeah. Don't know what else I'll get up to after Space 1999, but there's a few things. I think something PD has season two coming up here. Anyways. That's it, that's all. You have a good day and keep smiling. Twitch, twitch.